Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In our previous class, we have been discussed about the rediscovery of the Mendelian work, and even we have been discussed certain basic terms also we have been discussed here. Like what is the meaning of gene, what is the meaning of alleles, locus, phenotype, genotype, homozygous condition, heterozygous condition, dominant gene and recessive gene. So you know very well. So how inside the cell, what it hence every, you know, how many cells are present inside our body? In every cell, the nucleus will be present, and inside the nucleus, 46 chromosomes will be present, and inside 46 chromosomes, the genes will be present, which is holding the character. So genes, what they do? Genes will hold the characters which is present in your body, and all the genes where they will be having the alleles. All the genes will be represented in the form of a alleles. Alleles we are representing in the form of a capital letters or either in the form of a small letters. So capital letters, it will indicate the dominancy, whereas the small letters, it will indicate the recessiveness, it will indicate here. And where the genes, it will sit on the chromosome, that place we are calling it as a locus. If the genes, they are in a same manner, means we are calling it as a homozygous condition. If they are in different in condition, that means we are calling it as a heterozygous, because capital T is different, small t is different. Now this condition we are calling it as a heterozygous condition. And among that, so always the dominant, it will express in the form of a capital letters, and recessive it will be expressed in the form of a small letters. And who will be the dominant? That gene, it will express its character. The genes which are dominant, they will express their character. And the gene which are recessive, they will always they'll be in a suppressing condition. As I said you in my previous class also, if father is tall, means in his body, the character gene will be capital T, small t, it will be present. If mother, she is dwarf, means small, means in their body, small t, it will be present. So a child, it may get either this character or that character. So who will be the dominant? That character will be expressed in the body. So up to here we have been discussed in our previous class. So next let us discuss about the what term is hybrid. Next let us discuss our next term, call it as a hybrid. Hybrid to whom we are calling is offsprings which we will get from the parents. That offsprings we are calling it as a hybrid. That means yeah, young ones we are calling it as a hybrid. So you know very well. So parents will get their offsprings. So offsprings, another one term we are calling it as a hybrid. Here we are indicating in the form of a hybrid. And offsprings born from two their parents which are genetically different in one or more characters is called as hybrid. So what is the meaning of hybrid? Means the offspring, the child which we get from the two parents, because you know very well, if we want to get one child here, means our offspring, means two parents are responsible in the sexual reproduction. So all these things, it will take place through the sexual reproduction only. So that's why how many parents are responsible? Two parents here. So that the child which will be born from these two parents, and in that child they will be having the genetic difference in one or more characters. So compared to their parents, and the, in the child body, if they having the genetically differences, means we are calling it as a hybrid. Or else here the offsprings we are calling it as a hybrid, that you keep remember. So hybrid means offsprings we will get from the two parents, we are calling it as a hybrid. Next term, monohybrid here. So monohybrid means a hybrid organism obtained by cross the two homozygous condition differing in one contrasting character is called as monohybrid. So mono means what here? Mono means one. Mono is the meaning of mono, means mono means one. So here two parents are crossing with each other by taking one character. So two parents there. Which are the two parents? Father and mother. So we are crossing the father and the mother in order to get the young ones. So in that father and mother, we are taking only one character, and crossing with the parent for one character is called as monohybrid. Crossing with one character means either example as you take here, father. Father is indicated in this manner. Already have been studied in your 5th standard. This is the indication symbols to write the male and female. So this is the father and this is the mother. So both we are crossing. That means here we are hybridization we are doing, crossing here. So by taking how many characters? Only one character. Which is that one character? We'll take that tall character. Father, this is only one character. So that's why the name also we are given it as a mono. Mono means one. One character. Why we are crossing the, by taking one character, we are crossing the two parents. So tall, dwarf. So how many characters we have took here? Only one character. Which is that one character? Height character. Which is that one character? Height character. So we took the height character and we are crossing that two parents in order to get the hybrid. Now we will get the offspring. We will get the hybrid. We will get now offspring. They will get which character? What type of offspring they will get? Yeah, the offspring will also born in a tall, but the alleles will be different. Capital T, small t, like this. But here the fathers they having the genotype will be capital T, capital T. Mother they having the small t, small t. So father is also tall. But offspring also which has been born, it he is also a tall. Father is also tall. Abba bhi unche hi. But the baby which they have been got here, or offspring which they got here, or hybrid which they got here, they it is also in a tall. Unhe bhi bachcha bhi kaisa hai? Uncha hai. Father bhi unche hi, bachcha bhi uncha hai. But externally both they are long. But if you take internally, phenotypically means inside the father body, so capital T dominant alleles are present. Homozygote genes are present. In the offspring, so heterozygous alleles are present. This is the difference. But externally we can't know here. If you go internally, if you take the blood group and if you if you take the chromosomes and if you check means, then we can come to know that so father it may having this type of alleles, homozygous genes, and the child it is having the what type of alleles here? Heterozygous here. But it is externally phenotypically father is also tall, mother is also tall. Now this T which has came arise from whom? This T it has came from the mother. So mother ki gene is also present in the offspring. Maa ka gene bhi bache mein hai. Lekin it is in which condition? It is in a recessive in condition it is present. But it is present in which condition? It is present in a recessive condition, hidden in condition. Inside her body it is in a hidden in condition. And whose character has been expressed means father character has been expressed. So that's why hybrid it is born in a which condition means it is born in a tall in condition. So in this manner, taking one character, एक कैरेक्टर लेको इफ यू क्रॉस द टू पेरेंट्स मीन्स वी आर कॉलिंग इट एज ए मानो हाइब्रिड आर एस या राउंड सी राउंड सीड एंड व्रिंकल सीड सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन कैरेक्टर राउंड सीड सीड शेप वी आर टेकिंग विच कैरेक्टर शेप कैरेक्टर shape character. Here we took the which character? Height character we took here. Only one character. Here we are taking one character. Which character? Shape character. So shape, two types of shape we'll get. Round shape, another one is the wrinkle shape. Two types of shape we will get here. Two different shape we get. Round shape and wrinkle shape. So father it is in a round shape. Or mother it is in a round shape. Father it is in a wrinkle shape. Means the offspring they will get here. The father they may get here. Round shape they will get here. That means whose character has been expressed here? Mother character it is expressed. But father character is also present in their body. But it will be in a hidden in condition. So that's why crossing the what here means crossing the two different parents and opted by taking one character is called as monohybrid cross we are calling. So we are calling it as a monohybrid cross we used to call. Next month is the dihybrid cross. Next month we are calling it as a dihybrid cross. Di means the name itself, it shows what is the meaning. Di means two. So an offspring born with the two parents, same manner, mono and di. So in here we are taking one character and we are crossing the parents. Here we are taking the two characters. Here what we are taking? We are taking the two characters and we are crossing the parents here. Dihybrid cross here. Di means two. Taking the two characters and crossing with the parents and to get an offspring is called as dihybrid cross. So later briefly we will come to know this one. Two characters it will be present in the body. So briefly while doing the checkerboard, we'll come to know about this one. Just dihybrid means you keep remember here. So there are two characters. So round character, shape character is one, color character is one. So round character, shape character is one character, another color character is one. These are the two character. Shape it will comes round and wrinkle, and as a color character it will comes yellow and green. So like that two characters may be appear. Further briefly will explain you this one, that time you can know very well here. So dihybrid means crossing by taking the two characters and crossing the parents in order to get a young ones is called as dihybrid cross. Monohybrid means one character. Dihybrid means two character. Crossing by taking one character and crossing the parent. Here by taking the two characters and crossing the parent is called as a dihybrid cross here. Next, let us discuss the next term here. Next term is a filials. Next term what is here means? Next term we are connected as a filials. Filials means the filials are the offsprings produced by cross between the two parental forms here. That means here filials are the offsprings produced by cross between the two parent forms here. Filial means that filial we are indicating in the form of a generation. Filial means what here? Filial we are indicating in the form of a generation. Like how you know very well your generation. So suppose you are one generation. So your father is one generation. Your grandparents are one generation. So like that, from your grandparents, your parents have been erased. So first filial generation. From your parents, you people you have been erased. So and you are the another filial generation. So your parents are first filial generation. You are the second filial generation. So like that. So your grandparents, assume that. You know very well, from generation to generation we will come here. One generation to another generation. Every generation we are indicating in the form of a filials. And we are giving the name. First filial generation, second filial generation. If your parents are first filial generation, means from your parents you have been erased. So you will be the second filial generation. That is the F2 generation. So that's why first filial generation means the first generation of offspring produced by crossing involved the two breeds parents. So first filial generation. So your grandfather and your grandmother, both have been crossed and your parents have been erased. So your parents will be the first generation. And next second filial generation, the second generation offsprings produced due to the cross involved between the F1 generation. So who is the F1 generation? Your parents are the F1 generation. Crossing, it has been done by your parents, and if you people you have been appeared, means you will be the F2 generation. You will be the F2 generation. Next is the text cross here. Text cross means a cross made between the F1 hybrid with its recessive parents is called as test cross or the back cross here. So what is the meaning of test cross means? The cross made between the F1 hybrid here. So now in the plants, suppose here father and mother. So who is the father? Father and mother we got. So father and mother has been crossed and they got the offspring. That is first filial generation. F1 generation. Father and mother. Who is father? He is the father and she is the mother. He is the father and she is the mother. Father and mother has been crossed and they got the offspring. So this is the first filial generation we got. Now crossing this F1 generation with the recessive parent. Who is the recessive parent? Assume that mother is the recessive parent. Assume that mother, either mother if it is the recessive parent or father if it is the recessive parent, whoever it may be, we will not consider that who is the mother or father. Among that, who will be recessive? Crossing the offspring with the recessive parent. So that's why the cross made between the F1 hybrid. Who is the F1 hybrid? The child which they got here, this is the F1 hybrid. This is the F1 hybrid. This is the offspring they got here. So this is the F1 hybrid. Now crossing this F1 hybrid, I'll write here F1 hybrid with the recessive. Who is the recessive? Assume that mother is the recessive. Crossing the offspring with the mother and getting another offspring is called as test cross. So cross made between F1 hybrid with its recessive parent. So here we are not mentioning mother or father. So who is recessive? That parent. Recessive parent is called as test cross. Crossing the F1 hybrid with the recessive parent is called as test cross. So this is about your test cross. And Punnett's square or a checkerboard, it will come. So it is a square used to combine the gametes, two parents, to generate the genotype to determine the phenotype. Just to keep remember. So in next class, when I'll do this monohybrid and dihybrid, so that time I'll show you what is the checkerboard. So to whom we are calling it as a checkerboard. So this is the terms here. Next, these are the different basic terms that you should know very well. So what to study this chapter. Next topic, let us discuss what is the difference between the phenotype and genotype. So phenotype means external character which will appears on the body. Genotype means further external character with the genes which is represented, we are calling it as a genotype. So first difference between the phenotype and genotype means it is referred to external visible morphological character of an organism. Just now as I said here, phenotype means what here? It will represent only for the external character, whereas genotype means it will represent to the genetic constitution. That means it will represent to the genes. As I said here, phenotypic character is tall. The girl is tall or the boy is tall. The tall character, it is represented in the form of a genes. Capital T, capital T, capital T or small t. So that is the genotype. Genetically constitution, that means genes constitution we are adding like this. This is the genotype we are calling. Next, it changes with age. What you mean? It changes with the age. Phenotypic characters, it may get a change. It may get a changes with the age. Example here, the girl, she may be fair before, but later she may turns into the black color. Phenotypic characters, it may get changes according to the age. So even the height of the person, he may be having the height, but as the age it is going on here, his height may be reduced and he may be start for bending. So height may, it may be characters may be change here. Phenotypic characters, it may be change according to the age or else according to the environmental condition. So according to the environmental condition also it may get changed. Suppose a girl or a boy, he is very fair. As he was daily was playing in the heavy sunlight, due to that one, that fairness has been turned into the what you mean black color. So it may get changed. Phenotypic character is the color. It may get changed here. But genotypic character, it will not get changed. With this genotype, he will bring by birth here and it will be remains till his death. It will not get changed due to the say external characters, or it will not change due to the age, or it will not change due to applying any other substances. It will not get a change. So in their body, if they are having this type of illness, it will be remains as it is till he died. So that's why the phenotypic characters, it may change here, whereas genotypic character, it will not get a change. Next, it is affected by environment. So phenotypic characters may get affected. So just now I said here, a boy, a girl, or boy, a boy or a girl, she was very fair, but due to the external character like heavy sunlight, all these things, his color may be dim and he may turn to the black color. So it may be affected by the environment here, but here it is not influenced by environment. If any environmental changes appear also, the genes which is present in their body, it will not get a change. By birth he will bring here, it will be remains till his death. Whatever the changes it may be appear, the phenotypic characters will be remains as it is in their body. Next, phenotypic is limited to genotype, whereas genotype is not limited to phenotype. What you mean is phenotype is limited to the genotype here. Phenotype, it will be depend on the genotype here. So phenotype, it will depends on the genes, genotype. That means here, what type of genes are present here, on that basis only the external characters will be appear. So that's why phenotype is limited to the genotype. But genotype, it will not depend on the phenotype. So genes will not depend. If the external character, the person is tall here means, so the genes will not depend on the tallness of that. The genes will not depend on the phenotype. That is the meaning. So phenotype will depend on the gene, but genotype will not depend on the phenotype. So that is the meaning. Phenotype is limited by the genotype, but here genotype is not limited by the phenotype. Genotype will not depend on the phenotype here. So who is depending? Phenotype will depend on the genotype. So this is the difference between what here, phenotype and the genotype here. Next, another difference they have been given here, difference between the homozygous and the heterozygous condition. So first difference what here means, homo means, as I said here, same. Hetero means different here. So here similar pairs of genes for a character it is present. So never well, so similar pair of genes are present here. Same pairs of genes are present. So like capital T, small t, same genes will be present here. Heterozygous means dissimilar pair of genes will be present here. Dissimilar means capital T, small t, it will be present. Like the dissimilar, it will be present. Next one. It is two types here. So it's a homozygous condition. In homozygous condition, we will get the two types. So which are the two types? Means homozygous dominant will get here, recessive will get here. Dominant homozygous. Who is the capital T? Capital T. So these are the homozygous dominant it is present. Small t, it is a recessive homozygous it is present. But in this case here, heterozygous will get only one type. So this type, capital T, small t. So this only one type will get here. But here we'll get the two types we will get. Next one, here only one type of gametes is produced. Here only one type of gamete is produced here. So here only one type means, suppose capital T is T is there. Means from here we'll get only one gamete will be released into the offspring. Suppose in your father, capital T is there. Means in your body, only one gamete will be released here. Capital T gamete will be released here. But here, two gametes will be released here. Suppose here capital T like this it is present. Means it will be released two gametes. This is one gamete, this is one gamete. So later you will understand briefly this one. So two gametes, because both are different here, so that's why two gametes will be released. This is one gamete, this is one gamete. Two gametes will be released. This later briefly you'll understand this one. Next here both the factors express their character. So in homozygous condition, capital T if it's there, means this capital T also it will express its character. This capital T also it will express its character. Or else here, if this type it is present, means this small t also expresses dwarfness. This small t also it will express its dwarfness here. Both they are expressing their dwarfness. Here both they are expressing their tallness here. But in this case, it is not like that here. So one will express, one will be recessive in condition. So only who will be dominant here? This T only it will be express its tallness. But this small t, it is unable to express its character. It is unable to express its dwarfness. So that's why it will be in a hidden in condition inside the body. So only who will express here? It will express capital T only it will get express. This it will be in a hidden in condition. So this it will be in a hidden in condition. Again and again I am telling. So capital T also it is showing the tallness. Capital T also it is showing the tallness. So here small t also showing the dwarfness. Small t also showing the dwarfness. So both they will shows their express their what I mean is both they'll express their character. But here, so this is the capital T, this is the small t. So who is dominant here? Capital T, it will tell I am dominant. So I will express the character. So you keep quiet. So like that, it will hide for this one. It will not allow to express this character. So that's why here only the dominant factor expresses the character. The small it will be in a hidden in condition. Next, it is a pure breeding. So because they are in a homozygous in condition, same characters will be follow here. So it may get it transmitted. So that's why we are going to say pure breeding. This one we are calling it as a impure breeding, we are calling, because it is a mixture, because tall character is also there, small character is also there. So that's why we are calling it as a impure breeding we are calling. So we'll stop here. Let remaining we'll discuss in your next class. So related to that, if you didn't understand anything, means you can ask by calling me or by contacting me. So next we'll discuss in your later classes.